This is In His Blood, an Eve Hope FBI suspense thriller, book one. Written by Kate Bold, narrated by Sarah Tyndal. Prologue. Sierra Maybach frowned, glaring at the book in her lap without reading a word. The paperback novel, which she'd intended to enjoy while she sunbathed on the inflatable pool lounger, was still open to page one. She'd read the first sentence so many times she was sick of it, but every time she found her thoughts fuming angrily in other directions before getting to the second paragraph. She cursed time zones for existing, the Wilcox Trust International Company for sending her husband to Beijing, and her husband himself for extending the stay another 3 weeks. Phone calls between them were rare because of the time difference. She had woken up to a long email explaining why he must stay longer, how it broke his heart to be away, but unfortunately he was too essential to the securing of company interests in blah, blah, blah. She'd heard the song before, but every time the disappointment, frustration, suspicion, and longing were made fresh as a whip cut. The Maybach's two-story tutor cast a narrow band of shade that was slowly growing out towards the pool. On the deck table, a small portable speaker linked to Sierra's phone streamed sugary pop tunes into the sleepy Friday afternoon atmosphere. The phone itself was on the table beside the speaker, plugged into a solar-powered charging brick. Sierra heard the creak of her side yard gate. How long had she been putting off treating those hinges with a WD-40? The floating lounger was facing away from the house, so she had to crane her neck to look over her shoulder in the direction of the side yard. She saw a glimpse of motion as somebody stepped into the shadow of the house. The portable speaker's volume started to increase. Sierra frowned, slipped her feet into the water, and began kicking, turning herself around. "Oh," she said when the lounger had made the slow 180. "It's you. I wasn't expecting to see you today," she grinned, a bleach-white, sun-drunk kind of smile, at the man who must have let himself in the side gate. The breeze picked up a little, drifting the lounger in another lazy circle, while the leaves susurrated in the birches. The inflatable headrest bounced gently against the edge of the concrete stairs in the shallow end. Sierra was just turning her attention back to her open pages when a shadow fell across the book. She glanced up and saw the man standing over her. His face was perfectly calm, although his eyes were screwed up as if he were trying to read over her shoulder. The man still hadn't spoken since entering Sierra's yard. She laughed. "Come on, get out of here, you're in my light." Her giggles of protest were lost to the electronic music. "What are you doing?" she asked, an uneasy note slipping into her voice as the man slowly knelt, one knee on the tile lip of the pool. Sierra began trying to turn the lounger in a circle once again. The man's silence was starting to put her on edge. As soon as her foot touched the water, however, the man's hand shot out, seizing Sierra by the throat. The hand was thin and bony, but strong, nearly encircling her whole neck in its vice-like grip. The squeeze forced her airway shut. In a wild panic, she tried to scream, but before she had time to execute even this most basic defense, the hand was applying more pressure. Sierra's eyes were wide with crazed fear, her lungs filling with pool water. But still, the hand forced her down. Her mind swam crazily as her body steadily depleted its oxygen, trying and failing to comprehend what was happening to her. Through the water, she could see the distorted face of the man. "Why?" her mind cried out in anguished confusion, even as the darkness closed in and her consciousness flickered. "Why now? Why you?" her vision tunneled. Her body stopped fighting. An absurd thought struck her in the twilight of her life as her brain malfunctioned and petered out. "Oh no, my book's getting wet." Chapter 1. The swallowtail butterfly landed on the window of Eve Hope's kitchen while she was brewing coffee. It was 6:30 in the morning, but already Eve had been awake for 2 hours, jogged 4 miles, eaten a small breakfast, done 30 minutes of a Krav Maga workout, and showered. Now she sat at her kitchen table while the Java maker percolated, gazing thoughtfully at the jewel-winged insect outside her window. Butterflies always made...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.